Hello dear children, welcome to the maths class. See, last day we have seen how to graphically represent a linear equation in two variables. What did we do there? As we have found out solutions, the same way we will be finding the solutions, and each of the solution will be giving a point on the coordinate plane. Then you plot all the points. Minimum you require 3 points for plotting the point graph. And you plot the points, join it with using a scale, you will get a straight line for the graph. And then we had some conclusions. What were the conclusions? One is that the graph of a linear equation is a straight line. Second is all points on the graph will be solution. Third, all solutions will be on the graph. The solutions that what we get as an ordered pair will be on the graph. And fourth one, any linear equation of the form y equals mx will pass through the origin. Those were the four conclusions. And at that time I told you, we will be having certain questions where you will be given statements. Statements are given. First you will have to algebraically form the linear equation and then draw the graph for that. So today we will be doing some questions from the textbook, exercise 4.3. Two, three questions we will be doing. So all of you will be having your text with you, I hope. Open up the text, take exercise 4.3. Today there won't be any PPT to supplement your work. What I am taking here, you will be doing it in your notebook. So the graph I won't be drawing, I'll be only discussing how to do the question. That is how to form the linear equation, I'll be telling you. I'll be also telling you two, three solutions also I can tell you. The graphical part working out, you will be doing it. So I won't be doing any PPT today. So you can do the work. So three questions you'll be doing. So take that exercise 4.3. Take question number 4. Now I'll read out the question for you. The question is, the taxi fare in a city is as follows. A taxi fare. You know, see, for traveling, most of us go by autos and all. So there is a fixed charge for the auto. You would have noticed if you have traveled by auto, you would have noticed it. See, for the first 1.5 kilometers, they will charge you, I think now it is 25 rupees. 25 rupees, I think. So that's a minimum charge. This, whether you go for 1 kilometer or 1.5 kilometer, you will have to pay 25 rupees. That is a minimum charge. And after that, for every 1 kilometer, you will have to pay so much money. That is how the fare goes. So same way here, we are having a question. The taxi fare of a city is as follows. How is it? For the first kilometer. So the first kilometer, what is the fare? It is 8 rupees. That is, for the first 1 kilometer, the fare is rupees 8. And for the subsequent distance, subsequent means what? For the coming distances, whether it is 2 kilometers or 4 kilometers, that is after this 1 kilometer, whatever distance it is coming, the subsequent distances, each kilometer, the rate is rupees 5 per kilometer. 5 per kilometer means for each kilometer, the rate is rupees 5. So for first 1 kilometer, it is 8 rupees. It is fixed. For the further traveling, for every 1 kilometer, you will have to pay an amount of rupees 5 for 1 kilometer. Like that, how much per kilometer you are moving, you will have to pay the money. Now, the question is, taking the distance covered as x kilometer. So, distance you are taking as the variable x, and the total fare. That is, fare means the amount what you have to pay as rupees y. So both the variables you are having, x is the distance covered, total distance covered, and y is the total fare or amount that you have to pay for how much of a distance you have traveled. So if this is the condition, you will have to write a linear equation for this information and then draw the graph. Well, let us see how we are going to form the linear equation first. So total distance covered is x kilometer. So suppose this much distance I am covering. This distance is x kilometer. The total distance. In that, for the first 1 kilometer, what is the rate? ₹8. So suppose this is 1 kilometer. 1 kilometer. For this 1 kilometer, it is ₹8. 8 rupees you have to give for this 1 kilometer. And for this subsequent means after this 1 kilometer, what is the total distance? X kilometer. From that 1 kilometer gone. 1 kilometer we are not considering because it is ₹8. The remaining distance, total X kilometer, 1 kilometer gone. What is the remaining distance? Total X, 1 kilometer gone. So what is this remaining distance? This one, from here till here, the remaining distance is X minus 1 kilometer. Total distance traveled is X kilometer. Of that, this 1 kilometer distance fare I have already taken away. That is ₹8. That is fixed. For the remaining distance, what is remaining distance? X minus 1 kilometer. How did you get X minus 1? Total distance X, 1 kilometer gone. So total now it is, the remaining distance is X minus 1 kilometer. Here what is the condition given? For every 1 kilometer in this X minus 1 kilometers, the rate is ₹5 per kilometer. That is, for every 1 kilometer you will have to pay ₹5. So this is 1 kilometer. Suppose this is 1 kilometer from here, you will pay ₹5. Again 1 kilometer will pay ₹5. Again 1 kilometer will pay ₹5. Like that, for what distance? X minus 1 kilometer. So what is the fare, or what is the amount you will have to pay for this X minus 1 kilometers? For 1 kilometer it is ₹5. 2 kilometers, 5 into 2, 10. 3 kilometers, 5 into 3, 15. 10 kilometers, suppose it is there, 10 into 5, ₹50. So if there is X minus 1 kilometer, what is the amount that you have to pay? That is, for this distance, X minus 1 kilometers, it would be, the rate for 1 kilometer is 5, distance covered is X minus 1. So what is the total fare for this distance, X minus 1 kilometers? It will be 5 into X minus 1. This much rupees, this much amount you will have to pay for X minus 1 kilometer. Is it clear? This is for X minus 1 kilometer. Now it is given the total fare is rupees Y. So total fare is Y. How you are getting this total fare Y? Total fare Y is the sum of the fare for this 1 kilometer plus the fare for this X minus 1 kilometers. So what is the sum, amount for this 1 kilometer? ₹8. Plus for the remaining distance, what is the amount you have to give? 5 into X minus 1. So this is the equation. It's not in the standard form now. You will now open the bracket and write it in the standard form. So understood how you got this equation? This is the fare for the first 1 kilometer, and this is the fare for the remaining distance. At what rate? At ₹5 per kilometer. So this will be Y equals 8 plus 5X minus 5. You are opening the bracket, multiply with each term inside. So Y is equal to 8 minus 5 is 3. So 5X plus 3. This is our required equation. So we have formed the equation from the statement what is given. Now you should be drawing the graph for this equation. Now this is already given in the form where it has become easy for us now, isn't it? Y has been written in terms of X. So what you will do? You will assign values for X, find a value for Y, and plot the graph using the points X and Y. Minimum you require 3 points. So one or two we'll discuss here. Say X, Y. See, you, when you are writing, you will be writing when X equals so much, what is the value of Y, like that. I'm just simply saying how to do this. Okay. So when X is 0, when X value is 0, what is the value of Y? This becomes 5 into 0 is 0 plus 3, 3. So what is the value of Y? 3. Now when X equals, say, 1, X is 1. What is the value of Y? 5 into 1, 5 plus 3. What is it? 8. Now, when x equals, say, minus 1. See, actually this minus 1 won't come. Why? Because here x is taken as a distance. Distance will not be negative. But for the purpose of drawing the graph, you can take the negative value. Is it clear? Okay, so if suppose it is minus 1, x is minus 1, what would be this value? Y will be equal to 5 into minus 1 is minus 5. So minus 5 plus 3 will be minus 2. So 3 points you have got. Now you can plot the graph. Is it clear for you how to do this? So you may get questions like this. Only thing is you have to analyze the situation and convert the statements into a linear equation. Is it clear? Now take a question number 5. Now in that question number 5, the question is, from the choices given below, choose the equation where graph are given in figure 1 and figure 2. So two figures are given there, that is two graphs are given, and for each graph, 4 equations are given. You will have to find out which of those equations is actually represented by that graph. How you are going to do this? I am going to do question number, that figure 1. Question number 5, that first figure I am going to do. So first figure, just look into your textbook. The first figure, see the graph. Now we have learned from the graph, graph of the linear equations, one conclusion. What is that conclusion? Every point on the graph is a solution. Is a solution of the linear equation. So in that graph, certain points are given for us. Which are the points given? Say minus 1, 1, 0, 0, and 1, minus 1. These are the 3 points given for the first figure. And these, that is y equals x, x plus y equals 0, y equals 2x, 2 plus 3y equals 7x. These are the equations given. Now you will have to find out which among these equations is represented by this particular graph. So from the graph we have seen, these are the solutions. Now if these are solutions, what does it mean? This is the value of x and this is the value of y. Here also this is the value of x, this is the value of y. This is the value of x, this is the value of y. So you are going to find out from these equations, which of these equations has these 3 solutions, all the 3 solutions. Only then you can draw that graph, isn't it? So you are going to find out from this given equations, which of these equations will have all these 3 solutions, not just one. So maybe sometimes only one may be the correct solution for the given any one of these equations. But no, we are concerned with, because all these are solutions, that is why they form that line, or they are on the graph of the particular linear equation. So you are going to put the values for x and y and see where all these 3 solutions satisfy which of these equations. So let us take one by one. Let us take the first equation, y equals x. See whether it is satisfied or not. So first solution itself let us take. What is the value of x? X is minus 1, y is 1. X is minus 1, y equals 1. Is it equal? Y is equal to x, that is the equation. Means whatever be the value of y will be the value for x. So will this be the equation? Because here x is minus 1, y is 1. But the equation is y equals x. So anyway, this equation won't be the required one. So leave it. Take the next equation, x plus y equal to 0. X plus y equals 0. So substitute the values. First case let us take. Minus 1, 1. That is x is minus 1, y is 1. X minus 1 plus y is 1. How much is this? 0. Isn't it equal to the right hand side? Yes, this is a solution. Next one. 0, 0. substitute here, x is 0, y is 0. What is the result? 0. It is again equal. Okay, that is also correct. Now third one let us take. X is 1, y is minus 1. 1 plus minus 1, 0. Same as the right hand side. Okay, all the three solutions satisfy this equation. So this can be one equation for the graph. But don't leave it. We are going to find for the remaining also. Maybe sometimes this equation also may satisfy. We don't know. So you have to find it out. It is now because it is given in the second case, we are finding it and then we'll say, okay, we'll stop it here. No, you will have to find for the remaining also. So what is the third equation? Y equals 2x. Let us see whether this is satisfied or not. First case, let us take. If any one of them is not being satisfied, then we can know the remaining also. Is no need of looking into the remaining. This is not the equation we can understand. So here x is minus 1. So this will be, and y is 1. So y is 1, x is 2 into minus 1. So is 1 equal to minus 2? Not equal to. So this is not a solution, which means if this is not a solution, it won't lie on the graph. So we can say y equals 2x is not the required equation. Go for the last one. 2 plus 3y equals 7x. Substitute and see. Minus 1. X is minus 1. Y is 1. So 2 plus 3 into 1 equals 7 into minus 1. X value is minus 1. So 2, 3 into 1 is 3. 2 plus 3 is 5. Equal to 7 into minus 1. Minus 7. Is 5 is equal to minus 7? No, it is not equal to. So will this be the required equation? No. So y equals x is not an equation. Y equals 2x is also not an equation. 2 plus 3y is also not the equation. Then which is the required equation? X plus y equals 0. So what did we actually do here? From the graph, we have taken the points on the graph. The points on the graph tell us that they are the solutions. So if it is a solution, what we will do, we will substitute the value for x and y, see whether left hand side and right hand side are equal. So in all the cases, we have substituted and we have found that only in this particular case, that is x plus y equals 0, these solutions are satisfied. Is it clear? So the same way you will be doing the second figure question also. Two questions are there. The second figure question also you will be doing. Is it clear? Now question 6 and 8 are not in the syllabus. It has been deleted. So question 6 and 8 we are not doing. Go to question number 7. What is question number 7? I'll just read it out. Yamini and Fatima, two students of class 9 of a school, together contributed rupees 100 towards the Prime Minister's relief fund to help the earthquake victims. So two children of class 9 by name Yamini and Fatima, together they contributed, means both of them put some money together. The amount is rupees 100 to a relief fund. Write a linear equation which satisfies this data. So you have to write a linear equation for this, and a hint is given for this. You may take their contributions as rupees x and rupees y. Draw the graph of the same. So one person's amount you can take it as rupees x and the other person's amount as rupees y. So let Yamini pay rupees x, that is Yamini, and the other one Fatima pay rupees y. Together they paid rupees 100. So when you're writing, you will write, let Yamini pay rupees x and let Fatima pay rupees y. So together they pay. Together means sum of these two amount, that is x plus y, together it is 100. So this is the required equation. X plus y equals 100. Now you will have to plot graph for this equation. So write one in terms of one variable in terms of the other. You are going to write x as equal to 100 minus y. Now here I would like to suggest a thing. That is, see, when you are taking values, please take bigger values. Why? You know, because this is 100. So supposing you are taking y as 1, 100 minus 1 will be 96. So the graph will be 96, 1. So that will be too big for us to note. And second case, if you take y equals 2, it is so close, very, very close. So last day when I have drawn the graph also, I have told you, you may take values which are farther. So that the graph, you will be getting it, you can draw a straight line. The line can be larger, a bigger line you will get. So here you take higher values. Okay. And so suppose I'm taking these three values, let us take x and y, three values let us take. If you take y as say 20, y is 20, what is the value of x then? 100 minus 20, x will be 80. Understood? So take bigger values, don't take 1, 2, 3 and all the nearby ones, because the graph will be too small, it will be very difficult for you even to plot it. So take bigger values in such cases. Now second case, let us take y as equal to 50. When y is 50, what would be the value of x? 100 minus 50, x is also 50. Third case, let us take y as equal to 40. Or you can take 80 or 70 or anything you can take. Bigger values you take. Y equals 80. When y is 80, what is the value of x? 100 minus 80, 20. So three values you have got. Now when you are plotting the graph, there again question comes. You are, till now we were using one unit as equal to one. One unit of the graph paper, you have taken it as one, isn't it? So you may be thinking, how we are going to take this 80 and 100 and all along the small graph paper. So for that, we are going to change the unit. That is, if you are taking the graph like this, you can take one unit as equal to 10. One unit equals 10, here it is rupees. So you can take one unit equals rupees 10. So as and when we have done for a graph, that is a, in class 8 and all, you have done graph work, isn't it? There you have taken to write the scale. You have, I think you would have done this, the scale. So scale, you will write one unit, that is along the x-axis or along the y-axis. X-axis one unit equals rupees 10 and y-axis also one unit equals rupees 10. You can write on the top of the graph. That is, we are now changing the scale. We are not taking it as 1. Here this is 0. So first 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, like this it is going. Here it is, you can take minus 10, minus 20, like that it is going. Same way for y-axis. Here it is 10, 20, like that it is going 30. Here it is minus 10, minus 20, minus 30, like that it will go. Now it is easy for us to plot the point. So first one, if it is y is 20, x is 80. So x is 80, somewhere here it will come, y is 20. You can plot the point. So I just an illustration only. I have not drawn the graph. It is for you to do the work, for you to understand only. I have just given a illustration how to take the scale. So when you're taking the scale, please mention here on the top of the graph what the scale is. You will write scale and then you will write x-axis one unit equals rupees 10, y-axis one unit equals rupees 10. So is that clear how to do the work? So today you will be doing these four questions. See, that second question where the graph is already been given in the textbook, you need not draw the graph. You only write the solutions as I have written here. Write, these are the solutions. Since these points fall on the graph, these are the solutions. Write like that. Write four equations and then for each equation substitute and then show whether it is satisfying or not. So hope you have understood to do the work. Thank you, children.